Good evening. Our project was to make the pair cement tool for the Sunbird platform.
So basically, we started with understanding the edX Aura, since they have already implemented the pair cement tool, and that is the biggest pair cement tool that is being implemented today. Moreover, it is open source. So we started with understanding the open edX's Aura's documentation and its code. So this is the overview of the work that we'll be discussing today. So this is something about the open edX's Aura. So basically, these are the steps involved in the LMS part, learning management system part of edX Aura. It starts with submitting your response, and the next phase is to learn how to assess response. Since the peer assessment process involves a lot of complications, so initially we must ensure that the user who is performing the peer assessment must understand what is it. The next phase comes assess peers. In this phase, the students assess the responses of other students who are also enrolled in the same course. And the next phase is assess your response. Since you have learned that how to assess the responses and you have seen how you have given the marks, so you can now judge your response. Since the point of view becomes wider, so you can correctly judge your own response. The next step involved in LMS part of edX Aura is staff grade. The course mentor assesses the response himself or herself. And the next is the procedure for evaluation of grades. In edX's Aura, what they do is they find the median of all the criteria, they sum it up, and they convert into a grade. And when the course has the staff assessment involved, since it is optional, all the courses don't have that. If it is involved, the final score is the score given by the staff. So we also thought about exploring other peer assessment tools that are available and are being implemented. So one was Spark Plus. It was not open source, but it was being implemented on a wide scale. But it was not required, and it was used to assess the contributions of the individuals working in a group. And similar tool was WebPA, but it was open source, but it does the same thing as Spark Plus. Another very good tool was peergrade.io. It has some unique features that are different from Aura. For example, it includes a rubrics library. edX's Aura does not have that. You have to manually write the different options, criteria, and it's a very hectic job. But in peergrade.io, you can do that automatically. So this is the comparison that we came through between OpenEdX's and Sunbird platform. The OpenEdX is modular, interdependent in code base. So if you make a change in an X block, then the change would be affected in some other part of the code as well. It is highly coupled, whereas the Sunbird is decoupled. edX uses Python, Django, MySQL, MongoDB, whereas Sunbird uses Java, Node.js, and Apache Cassandra. So we started with installing the Sunbird portal. For installing the Sunbird portal, it is specifically specified that you have to have the Ubuntu 16.04 LTS version. We tried using with 18th version, it does not work. You have to have the Node.js version 6.14.2. The newer versions are available, but it does not work on that. The NPM version has to be specifically this. Another issue is that you have to get the API key from the Sunbird guys. You have to mail them and request for the API keys. And moreover, further issue is that you have to manually set up the environment variables for Sunbird. It is not mentioned in the documentation, so it's an issue. So what we have done is we have adapted the data structure of somewhat similar to Aura. We have created almost 10 tables. That is, I think, the minimum amount of tables that you have to create a peer assessment tool. And we have uploaded the database on the cloud server from dbfree.net. So the next part, my colleague Khushbu will explain.
Our first approach was developing the GUI prototype. We developed it in GUI. Then we included the login and registration frames also. But when our tool would be integrated with the Sunbird platform, it wouldn't be needed, as this is required only in the developer version, and we needed a database. Now, this is our first frame. This would, over here, the instructor would be setting the questions, and a learner must be graded by minimum how many number of peers, and one must grade how many peers. Then over here the rubrics were set. Rubrics are is a collection of criteria. Now the evaluation of peers was supposed to be done on the basis of several criteria available. They demonstrate the characteristics of a question criteria. So for example, one such criteria can be the facts or ideas which were supported by the answer. On that basis, it could be judged, and for each criteria, there could be any number of options. Then we have sample, then the author would be setting the sample answers for the learner to learn how to assess the responses. Then over here, the if the author feels that he needs to edit the criteria, so he can click on the author can click on the edit criteria frame in the previous slide and edit it. Similarly, for editing the option, we had created this. Now the LMS side, over here the learner first starts with submitting the response, and the learner selects a course and then submits the response. Over here, the learner learns to assess the response on the basis of several criteria, and over here, the answers set by the author are displayed. Then over here, this is a peer assessment frame. Over here, we have kept anonymous IDs for the peers, and the peers' responses displayed, and accordingly, the for different criteria, different options are displayed according to the data set in the rubrics. And then the self-assessment, here the peer learns to assess himself, herself, and again the same way the learner assesses other peers. And then over here the result is displayed. Now this was the GUI prototype, but our second approach was developing a web application, so that will be explained by Indranil.
Good evening everyone. Like the first part of our project was to develop a prototype which is modeled in Java. This was basically due to the fact that Sunbird uses Java, and we developed our prototype in such a modular way that the data part, database handling part is totally modulated out so that it could be easily integrated into any form, and that too, like, we initially used SQL. So it was designed in such a way that you can easily switch it to Apache Cassandra, which is being used in Sunbird. So here's an overview of the web application. Like, we developed it only like in a few weeks earlier. So this is the CMS registration page where the content manager manages it, like registers. Then there's a CMS login web page. We used, there might be a question that why we use these login pages. This is solely for the development purpose. Like, and otherwise, you can use sessions to get into that part. So here's the part where you set the prompts for filling up the course and the questions. Here's the setting of rubrics part, which the author issues. Next is the LMS registration part and login part. Next is submitting of response. Like, the workflow goes like this. First you start, like, if we ignore the login part and directly pass on to the session, then we check that if the user has already submitted the response. If, like, he has already submitted the response, then we go on to the second checking part, where we check if he has learned to properly assess the question. Like, it's really important to properly ensure that he has really learned how to respond, else, like, it would have no value of grading. Then we move on to the peer assessment part. Like, after learning to respond, we check that we check the criteria which have been set by the CMS side for the number of assessors and the number of assessments to be made. And then we go on, after he has completed the peer assessment part, we move on to the self-assessment part, where we, like, if I have any doubt whether a person has assessed me wrong or right, so I will have some, like, a degree of freedom to judge my grades. Then we go on to the self-assessment part, and after that we go to grading part. So suppose it happens that my response has been distributed to several systems, several people, and suppose if they don't submit their response properly, or if I'm left alone, suppose my answer has been distributed to 5 people. So what's the basic thing that we do is, if the person 70% means, if the person's response has been 70% graded, like has been graded by 3 or 4 people, then we take on an algorithm to take a median out of those grades and grade it. And second part is auto grading, in which we, like, it's a future work. Of course, it was not possible in this scope of this internship. Like, we can do is use general machine learning algorithms to find out the, like, the one which we use to find out genre of certain summary. We can compare the previous answers which have been submitted and then compare it to the answer which is being submitted. And so according to that, we can grade it. So this is all for the workflow. So these are some basic UIs. Finally, it displays the result as self-grade and the peer grade. The issues that we faced was finding, like, we didn't start from scratch. Like, in this world, there is everything being made. So we tried on integrating something, but it was really tough, as like Sunbird uses Java. Our primary goal was to develop for Sunbird, and Sunbird uses Java. So it was pretty tough to find out. And we initially went through the documentation of OpenADX, and it was, as it was written in Python, like we had to go through like thousands of lines of code, but we adopted many means, but we had to start from scratch. Then was implementing of the database on a cloud server. It was hosted, like, to make it remote, and we made two methods. Like, one was web page mode, and another was on Java, which can be run in offline too. So the basic advantage of running on offline is that every time you have to go for a course, you have to go to OpenADX site. So, like, we made use of a prototype that you can easily integrate. Like, if a school is adopting that method, it can be easily run as an offline application too. Second was installing Sunbird portal. As mentioned, it was pretty difficult, as we had to get through environment variables and API keys. Next is integrating peer assessment tool with Sunbird platform. So this was the main issue that we had faced. And like, if it had been not faced, we would have integrated Cassandra into our existing tool. Then is implementing with Apache Cassandra. Like, the major reason to go for Apache Cassandra instead of SQL is that with the recent upcoming of big data, like when you have millions of users, non-clustered databases work better than, like, clustered databases work better than non-clustered. And here are a few points why we should use NoSQL methods. Our future work, as we didn't, like, Apache Cassandra was new to us and its concept was new to us. We didn't directly switch to Apache Cassandra because hosting sites are tough to find for it. So our future work might include switching on to Apache Cassandra database. Next is integrating of our web, like the web page which we designed to implement the peer assessment tool. You can easily integrate it into the iframes of the Sunbird course which you will make in future. So it can be easily implemented. We can work on, like, refining the GUI. And, like, there are many features that OpenADX Aura are using, but we are, like, not that advanced, but we can really, like, near about compete with them. Thank you. Any questions?
How easy or difficult it would be to adopt any available, what you can say, rubric library? At least the content of that, each component of rubric library,
Yes,
we should be able to adapt, I guess.
Sir. Sir, as basically mentioned, like we had to work on Sunbird, and Sunbird initially works on like Java.
Yeah.
So, but like OpenEDX initially works on Python and its frameworks. So like we had to build everything from scratch, and for Rubrik's library, we have many online tools to create it. But like everything is not open source. So that's the major issue.
Even peergrade.io,
yes,
you mentioned it's freeware,
yes, sir,
but not necessarily open source.
No, no, it's not open
source. So that is a very interesting this thing. I am not very sure we should, where that free software has its own limitations on usage.
Yes, sir.
Lastly, why do you say that some platform, because it is built on essentially on Java framework, whereas the other one is, let's say, Django Python, there is a problem? Why should there be a problem? Because if I have a platform which is built around microservices, then I should be able to add on to those microservices, use those APIs to connect with any damn thing built on any technology. So why do you think there is a problem?
Sir, there might be problem because like if you use like you will be using some libraries to like Jython must be the library by which you can use Python's code to Java. I think so. I have not been like.
No, but why do I need to make to write a Python code which actually integrates with physically with the code on the Sunbird platform at all? Why can't, for example, the entire Aura segment be an equivalent of XBlock?
Yes, sir.
Just like XBlock can be written using absolutely any technology,
yes, sir,
but it will work with OpenEdX.
Yes,
why can't I think of repurposing the existing Aura framework exactly as it is and use it merely as an add-on to Sunbird as a service?
Sir, first thing, while using library, your complexity will grow.
You didn't get to play with Cassandra enough. That
no,
is
sir.
What you're saying.
No, sir.
It's unfortunate because you could have learned very useful things,
yes,
using
sir.
Cassandra. Did you have at least a peep into,
yes, sir,
SQL and other things?
Yes, sir. Like we had installed the system and tried to translate our queries into those, but as it was like 10 to 11 tables,
question
so it
of
was
time,
pretty.
Yeah. Anyway, good work. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Why you're hosting your database somewhere else?
Sir, as there was no present like free hosting site available, so we found
local. You don't on a machine?
We hosted it on a machine. Like to make it, like if I make one entry, like it's pretty painful for entering answers and stuffs on our own, right? So like if she enters the answer, like I would be easily be able to assess it. That's the whole point. Like we can share on our responses. Like if we install among like three machines and they have submitted an answer and I have to submit an answer, right? Then the system must be able to distribute my answer among these two. So if it's been hosted on my machine, they won't be getting my answer.
No.
That's the basic thing.
Why?
Sir, if we will host it on local server, then if I'm using it, then how will the other person get what I have submitted the response?
Why can't you install it on a VM which is shared by everyone?
Sir, like we had IITBX like provided to us, but we didn't go into those
codes. Sir, I just had one question. Yeah, just a minute. So you use self-assessment after peer assessment, right? So doesn't that defeat the purpose of having peer assessment?
No, sir. Suppose I dispute my answers about, right? And they have some animity with me, and they grade me low, but I think that my answer is good. So if suppose there comes the staff assessment part. So if there is a huge rift between the scores, the staff will get the feedback that there is a huge risk. And if you enable staff assessment, which is in the CMS part, the staff will get the notification and see on that.
No, but
so
what if...
For that, there is the self-assessment.
I don't think he knows what assessment they have been done by.
Okay.
It's an independent
Right, but it, since it is being done immediately yes, after sir? Peer assessment.
Yeah, but peer assessment,
sir, the whole thing is anonymous.
Okay, so the final will take into care the peer assessment also. Okay. But I just wanted to add one more comment on yours. So the fact that they have also included other peer assessment tools, not just the one that they are using, because there are several other studies which were lacking that. So they have included not just their tool, but the tool that they are using,
they
but
research, though.
Research those as well.
They are still not clear as to what particular tools should be used in the longer.
That's the difference.
I just wanted to share with you one very unintended use of peer assessment that we found when we ran this program as a part of the faculty development program. And in one module, every participant was supposed to upload an assignment, and that assignment was to be peer assessed. So we got a very frantic mail from one serious-minded person. He said that I was shocked that as a peer team, I was required to assess one submission, and that submission turned out to be exactly my submission with my name changed. So, we never thought peer assessment could lead to plagiarism detection, which was an incidental advantage. So, these temptations occur not only in the minds of students, but even in the minds of teachers. Basically, it's a human problem, not a student problem or something.
Thank you.